I'm out on site today with Nicky McNally, the founder, the managing director of McNally EV. I'm here to install the Zaptec Go, but I've also brought some extra toys, the Megger EVX100. Should make things a lot easier. Let's go. So you're still on the tools. How long until you start handing them over for good and just boss everyone around?
I don't think I ever will, to be honest. I love getting up in the morning and going to work and feeling like I've done something and got a graft in.
Now, if you've ever battled with other testers, you'll know the drill. Flicking through CP states manually like you're cracking a safe leads everywhere like you're setting up a dodgy tripwire. Absolute nightmare. But with the EVX100, none of that hassle. Just mount, connect, and let it do the work for you. Today, we're putting the Megger EVX100 through its paces. We'll be testing the Zaptec Go charge point alongside the MFT X1. Now, we could just take this straight to site and hope for the best, but that's not how we do things. Instead, we'll start in a controlled workshop environment, run through the key tests, then take it out into the real world, where we'll see how it performs in proper installation conditions. We'll also go over how the EVX100 automates testing cycling through test sequences without any manual intervention, making your job faster and easier. Plus, we'll transfer results to Megger Cert Suite, ensuring smooth documentation. Let's get into it. Let's talk power. The EVX100 runs on an internal 3180 mAh lithium-ion battery. So before we start, we need to make sure it's fully charged. Charging is simple. USB-C. Plug it in here and you're good to go. You'll see the LED indicator light up while it's charging. A full charge should last approximately 5 hours of continuous use before needing a recharge. One of the best features of the EVX100 is that it mounts directly onto the MFT X1. No extra cables, no faff. Just slide it onto the top until it clicks into place and the MFT X1 will automatically detect it. That means we now have access to all the EV charger test functions ready to go. If you've been running around with the Megger MFT X1 for some time now, you'll need to make sure you're on the latest version. I've already done a short video on this, so check that out. I'll leave a link in the description. If you're working on a three-phase charger, the MFT X1's got your back. It'll automatically display the phase sequence as soon as it picks up a three-phase connection. Just plug in, check the display, and crack on. So this is the setup. We're all up to date with the firmware. We've charged up here. Let's put it through its paces. The EVX100 can simulate an electric vehicle by cycling through CP states A, B and C automatically to the charger. No more scrambling around trying to switch states manually. Just sit back and let the magic happen. Let's check the loop impedance, ZS. This tells us if the earth fault path is effective, ensuring the charge point is properly earthed. The EVX100 automates this test, so all I have to do is select it on the X1 and the system takes care of the rest. If this reading were too high, that could indicate a poor earth connection or an issue with the supply wiring. Onto the RCD test, absolutely crucial for EV charge points. The EVX100 automates this too, so we don't need to manually reset the charger when the RCD trips. Just select the 30 milliamp RCD test on the MFT X1, run it, and let the tester do its thing. Now, let's talk about a crucial safety check, PE and CP error mode testing. The EVX100 lets us simulate faults to see how the charger responds. This is a big deal because a charger that doesn't detect these faults properly could present serious risks. First up, the PE protective earth error. The EVX100 will deliberately disconnect the earth and we should see the charger disable itself. If it doesn't, we've got a serious problem. Then there's the CP control pilot error mode. We simulate a CP failure to check if the charger correctly cuts off power. Again, if it doesn't react as expected, that's a red flag. Alright, everything's looking spot on here. Let's take it to site and see how it holds up in real world conditions. We're on site now, and as usual, we've got some real world challenges to deal with. The sun is out, but don't be deceived, it's cold. And since I don't have an EFX jumper, it's t-shirt weather for me, whether I like it or not. We'll run the exact same test we did in the workshop. Loop impedance, RCD trip, and PE and CP error check. And that's the charger, fully tested and ready for handover. Now, the best part, getting all this data into Megger Cert Suite. No messing around with paper reports, just connect the MFT X1, open Cert Suite and transfer the test results automatically. From here, I can generate a full test report, complete with all readings, ready to hand over to the client. So there you have it. From workshop to real world install, the Megger EVX100 makes EV charger testing fast, easy and accurate. If you're doing a lot of EV charge point installs, this setup could make life a whole lot easier. Automating tests, cycling through CP states and seamlessly transferring results. If you've had a nightmare EV install, drop it in the comments. Let's see who's had the worst job. Just want to thank McNally EV for installing the Zaptec Go, but how simple was it using the Megger EVX100? And how easy is it also to transfer the information across to the Cert Suite? If you want to find out that information, check out the video here.